Hey everybody, welcome in. Been a while since my last stream. Hey Chris, welcome in. I've been really busy just with everything, you know, channel-wise, life-wise, holiday-wise. It's just been crazy. So I figured I'd jump on tonight and play some Super Bullet Break, which is a pretty cool game, actually. I played a little bit, but we'll be starting a new game just so you guys can see what it's all about. And this won't be a super long stream, maybe like 2 hours, 2.5 tops. But yeah, it should be fun. So we'll get this started. So right now you can see, like, I can't actually select anything, it's all broken. So we're gonna check our messages. By the way, Chris, I hope you're doing well. Something of a pro gamer. I like how she's like, let me give you the rundown, and sends me a wall of text. Yo, those emotes are actually really cute. Okay, so basically, yeah, some site, you know, virus or something like that has basically infected all these games. We have to go in and set things straight so that we can play the games normally. And that's basically what all these stages are going to be consisting of. So when you start off, you can actually choose, or you can choose a random support bullet. You can summon up to 3 times. So I'll do a summon, and we can see this is the first one that we're getting, Squeaker. This actually isn't that bad, but it costs a lot. Let's try again. Rin Akatsuki. Gain plus 1 attack power for every card discarded this turn. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna use the last summon. We'll see. Ryoko Shirom. This one's actually pretty good. We'll go with this. Sorry guys, just give me one sec. There we go. Huh? Okay. Okay, so basically we get, you can see there's like a grid here. We can choose which path we want to go down. And each path usually offers something different. This one, it's going to be an event. We don't actually know what's going to happen. Could be good, could be bad. These are enemies, and they go from what I've seen, they go from 1-star to 3-star. And if you win, you get a new bullet. So those are always good. So I'll start off with this. You guys can see like what a battle looks like. So we have these bullets. These are basically like our cards. Each one has a different effect, a different attack stat, different range. And basically, this is going to be like your deck. So you're going to be basically using these to do attacks, to defend yourself, all that good stuff. If anyone's played something like Slay the Spire, it's a lot like that. So let me see. The first few fights are always the hardest because we start off with a really crappy deck that we kind of have to just work on as we go. So I'll use this one. This one, it's got a low cost. We have to discard a bullet, but it does pretty good damage, so. And there at the top, you guys can actually see there's a bar with the enemies on it. And how this works is that the number on the top left of the bullet, you see this one has a 7. That's how many, time blocks it's going to take to use this bullet. So, you know, if I go to this one, it's only 4. You can see at the top, it only takes 4 blocks. So the stronger cards take more blocks, which means that the enemy gets their turn sooner. So you kind of have to balance strong bullets that you can only use maybe once or twice before you get attacked, or weaker bullets that... you know, you can do more attacks before the enemy's turn comes. This one has burst, which means that every time I use a bullet, this one's attack goes up by 1. So that's pretty useful. So I'll keep attacking this one. We'll try to get rid of this guy. Okay, we'll finish up with this. This one, you can see the range is 3, so this one can attack all 3 at the same time. And there's actually 2 types. If you guys have played, again, like Slay the Spire, you know there's usually like a shield stat that you can buff yourself with to take less damage on the enemy's turn. This game has 2 stats for that. One is shield, one is armor. Shield disappears every turn, so it refreshes every turn and goes back to 0. Armor actually sticks around until it's been used up by being attacked. So armor is better, but usually it takes a lot more effort to get armor than it does to get shield. So. That bullet heals me every time I use it, so that one's useful. So also there because we had more shield than the enemy had attack. We didn't take any damage. And this, there's actually a couple buffs you can get in this game. One of them is Heart Explosion, which I think until it hits 100, nothing really happens. But you can see there, Heart Explosion is basically explaining that once you hit 100, it halves the cost of all Seasons bullets. Seasons, again, is something else. It's one of the cartridges, which is a whole other thing that you have to get into. But it delays all enemies as well, so it's actually pretty useful. So if you can use a lot of bullets that have Heart Explosion, you'll get that buff, and that can be really clutch during bosses and things like that. So at the end of every fight, you get some money, and it'll show you what your remaining health is, which goes between battles. You don't get your health back between battles unless you stop somewhere to rest or heal yourself with an item or something like that. So that's also really important to keep in mind. And at the end of battles, you get new bullets. So it'll give you a choice of three. You get to pick one. And it's always good to look at, first of all, like what the effect is, and the cartridge as well. The cartridge, for example, is where it says Spicy Circle. That's what the cartridge is. And there's a whole bunch of different ones. I mean, this one, Marine Madness, lowers the cost of the bullet by one. This one, the first bullet you use in combat has +4 attack power. So as long as I've got this in my deck, I get that bonus, which is pretty sick. And then this one, this bullet will always start in your hand, which is pretty good. I think I'm gonna go with... I can't remember what the laser effect is. This one actually does a lot of attack. I think I'll go with this, actually. So every bullet is actually, you know, like a little anime girl. Most of them are anyway. Some of them are animals and things like that. So whenever you get a new one, you get this little intro where you can see the actual CG of the character. And you get like a little intro dialogue. It only happens the first time though. But I'm pretty sure there's a gallery you can go back and you can actually look at them again. So I think I'll keep battling for now, because I'll get money and stuff for this. Hey Rose, welcome in. It's going pretty well. I'm gonna try to get through this stage without dying, which probably isn't gonna happen because I haven't unlocked anything yet. So my deck isn't gonna be that great. How's everything going with you? Good, I hope. I keep forgetting today is Saturday, right? Am I crazy? Yeah. Hope everyone's having a good weekend. Okay, let me see here. Okay, I think I'm gonna go with this one. This one has combo beam. Which basically combo beam, it's kind of a little thing you'll see. You can chain them, and every time you hit 10 combo with the combo beam cards, you do 30 damage, I believe, to a random enemy. So if you have a lot of bullets that have combo beam and you can just kind of rack that up really quickly, you can actually end up doing a lot of damage. So it's good to have a lot of them on in your deck. Not bad, just working on Sonic Frontiers 100%. Nice. Did you finish that update, that crazy update? Okay, we'll start with this. Let's try to get our combo up. So something to keep in mind too, you can actually see what the enemy is going to do on their next turn. So the icons that you can see above their health bar, you see there's a 12 and then there's a sword icon with an 18. So that sword icon with the 18 means that on his next turn, he's going to do an attack that's going to do 18 damage. So if I don't have armor or shield that comes up to 18 before I get attacked, I'm going to be taking the difference in damage. So I can either try to finish him off before his turn comes around, or I can try to heal or give myself armor before his turn comes around. But until like it's his turn, he can't really do anything. So you're able to kind of strategize based on that, you know, seeing what's coming up. Not yet, I want to 100% the base game first. I'm done with Three Islands, wrapping up the fourth. Nice. That's pretty awesome. I had so much fun playing Sonic Frontiers. Okay, what should I do? Let me see. I should try to heal a little bit. He's actually going to do a really strong attack. We're 36 on his next turn, so I'll try to get some shield in. Okay, so here's another one. This is actually a really good card, especially with the circuit board cartridge, because we get plus 2 attack power. But right off the bat, 12 damage for a 5 cost card is actually really good, and it gives plus 3 combo beam, and it's penetrating, which means it bypasses their armor or shield or whatever. So that's actually really good, and I think I'll probably go with that one.
もしかしてバンドに勧誘された子？言っとくけど、実力がなければ私は認めないわよ。
Okay, so we have a shopping section coming up. So I'll try to get that. Okay, so I'm running pretty low on health, but it should be okay. Because there's gonna be some rest stops coming up. Oh, this is actually a really good bullet. Because she has burst 5, which means that for every bullet I use that turn, her attack goes up by 5. So if I can like kind of stretch out the turn and use like a bunch of weaker bullets, then I can use her. She's only one cost. And it's very possible I can get her attack up pretty high. So she's actually really good. And these scout tickets, this is for when I'm at the shop. I can use these tickets to basically try to request certain bullets based on two categories that I get to choose. You guys will see when I actually do it, but I'll go with Rulo for now.
さあ、貴様もハル様に永遠の忠誠を誓うがいい。従わぬというなら、分かっているな。
All right, so we'll go with the shop. So the shop is going to cost more every time we go up a stage. So right now it's going to be the cheapest. It's going to be throughout the whole run. What I usually do is I'll discard one bullet. This is where you can go to get, throw away any bullets you don't want in your deck. So I always do this first, and we'll discard this one because I never use that one. Then I'll buy a scout ticket, and with the scout ticket, we can use that here. And it'll randomly give me two traits. So we can choose two traits and it'll give me a bullet it's basically any bullet that has those two traits. And you know, bullets have tons of traits. So if you can remember the traits that the bullets have, you can use this to kind of like pick some out or have a higher chance of getting some that you know you want. I don't personally remember or know the bullet traits at the moment, so I kind of just go with like anything that sounds good. I'll go with like Knight Fortress or Knight Witch. Let's try Knight Witch. Oh, that's not bad. So if we discard this bullet, we get 10 shield and 10 armor. That's actually pretty good.
テイルのあまりリコよ。良ければ私たちの歌を聴いてファンになってくれると嬉しい。今通った子超可愛いんだけど、こうしちゃいられないわ。早速私のファンにしなくちゃ。
All right. So I'll save my money, the rest of my money for now. You can also, if you can save up enough, you can actually buy the shopkeeper's bullet, which is pretty crazy. Like, restores 100% of damage dealt to his HP. So if you can do a lot of damage with the bullet. With buffs and things like that, you can get almost all your HP back. So there's a reason it costs as much as it does. Okay, so from here, we'll do another battle. I don't think I'm gonna die. I should be okay. I'll try to play it safe, just in case. So here, okay, so this is the one we just got, where if we discard it, you can tell it's not very strong, it's a one cost, it only does 4 damage, but if we discard it, we get 20 defense, basically. So this card, discards bullets to be activated. So I'm going to use this to discard her, and that just gave us 20 defense, which is enough to survive the next attack, so... It's got 50. Yeah, I think even if I try to go really hard, I'm not gonna finish it off this turn, so. I'll just try not to die. Oh, if I had one more turn, or one more block, I could have probably finished this enemy off. Am I gonna die? No. Oh, no way! The bullet that was at the shop that cost 1500 gold is one of the rewards for this. Okay, well, I'm taking that, obviously.
Konnichiwa! Watashi Natsu tte iu no. Bouken ni hitsuyou na item wa watashi ni itte kureleba itsu demo chougou shite ageru yo.
Okay, hopefully I can use that to heal me a little bit. I'm not gonna risk another fight because if I get hit really well in one turn, I'm gonna die. What I will do is discard that. We'll get another ticket. Okay, I wanna go with Singula Lady is usually like bosses and stuff. So if I go with, let's say, Vigorous Singular Lady, that should be pretty good. I mean, she's not bad, but she costs a lot. 12? She costs a lot, but I think, I mean, she can hit basically everybody on the field, and she does 20 damage. So she'd be good as, like, a finishing move type bullet. And I think that's pretty much everything I'll do for now. So these cubes basically are kind of like chance slots. You can choose one, and one of them has a bullet, one of them has money, the other one has an item. So, okay, so I got an item, restores 20 HP, not bad. And then the coffee spots are resting spots. You can either rest for free and get 30% of your HP back, or you can pay and get 50% of your HP back, which I don't think I have to pay, probably because of one of my bullets has a special ability for that. And then this is going to be the boss. Okay, so her first turn isn't going to be anything too crazy, so I'll kind of use this as an opportunity to get as much done as I can. Yeah, yikes. Her next turn, she's gonna do 60 damage. The music's pretty... Yeah, I actually like the music in this game. It is actually really cool. Okay, this is perfect. We'll discard her. That gives us an extra 20 defense. I'm literally just gonna pump myself full of defense if I can. Took 21 damage, that wasn't too bad. I need to find a way to buff this card so that I can make more HP back. Okay, she's gonna heal on the next turn, so that's okay. Woo! Okay, so she's gonna do 53 damage on her next turn. I think I can probably kill her before then. So that shouldn't be too much of a problem. So it'll always give you three of the same character after a boss fight, but the cartridge changes. So here we have a Blackwing gear, so it'll lower the cost of the bullet by two. This one's a Spooky Plushies, so it gives one HP every time I use it. And Black King's Carnage, where if I have 12 or more monochrome bullets in my magazine, inflict 3 delay on all enemies at the start of the turn. This one is going to be tough because I don't know how many monochrome I have in my deck right now. So I think I'll go with the cost minus 2. I like how they call them buggos. Okay, so that was the first map. Now things are gonna get harder. So I'll try to get, let me see. We're gonna need to like start buffing up quicker. So this one attacks twice, which is really good, especially since we have the cost minus 2 with the cartridge. Also, sorry guys, give me just one second here. Alright, so I'll use this first. Which one? This will go with this one first.
お花はいかがですか?
Okay, I'm not a fan of this card really, because the cost is really high for what it does. This one's not bad. Gain plus 4 attack for each enemy. That's good for groups. And we could get another one of these. This is actually pretty good, so I think I'll do that. You can also skip. If you want to, you can choose not to grab any cards. If none of them are good and you don't want them in your deck, that's also a good choice. Alright, let's get rid of some. Okay, I'm gonna get rid of her because I'm not a fan of those cards. We'll do another scout. Okay, let's try Rook. Rook Moon Viewer, I guess. Oh, she's cute. Lanterna. Gain plus 3 attack power for every card discarded this turn. And she has Burst 2, which means every time I use... every time I use a bullet, she's gonna get 2 attack on top of all that. So that's actually... not bad. Okay, I don't want to do a 2-star. I remember I made the mistake of doing a 2-star and even a 3-star at one point, and I was having a really, really good run, and I fought a 3-star and just got destroyed. So we're gonna rest instead. I'll take this opportunity to get some health back. And then we'll go back to the shop. Still got a lot of money, so... we'll get rid of this other one that I don't like, and buy another scout ticket. Yo, Tommy! Thank you very much, Tommy, for the sub, and welcome in. It's good to see you. I hope you're doing well. Thank you very much for that, by the way. I really appreciate that. Okay, so let's go with second year student... flamethrower, I guess. Sounds pretty good. She's not bad. She's a low cost. She doesn't really do very much. What a look for this game. I love it. Yeah, I was pleasantly surprised. Definitely pleasantly surprised by this game. I love the kind of the vibe it gives off. The music is really nice. The humor is pretty good, and the designs for the characters and stuff like that are always really good in this game. So I'm enjoying it, and I like deck building games, and I like roguelikes and roguelites. So this is definitely right up my alley. Alright, let's see... okay, these fights are actually pretty good, because the treasure chest doesn't really do anything for, like, 3 turns. So what you can do, if you can get rid of that first enemy quickly, then you can spend a couple turns healing yourself, or buffing yourself, which is really useful. It's kind of like a reprieve, you know what I mean? So I'm actually... we'll get rid of this guy as quickly as I can. Okay, so with this we can discard her. Oh, you know what though? I'm not gonna do it yet. I'll wait, because I think the treasure chest is gonna attack me. Maybe on the next turn? So I'll wait to do it on the next turn so that I can have the armor I need. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so he's gonna do 20 attack, or sorry, 28 attack, on his next turn. So if we discard her, that immediately gives us 20 defense, and then I can make up the rest with another bullet, probably. Let me see. Oh, there we go. This will finish him. Heal 2 times and gain 8 armor. That's not bad, but it's also... it costs a lot. You have to be really careful with the bullets that cost a lot. Later on, when there's a lot of enemies, when you're fighting like 3 or 4 enemies at a time, things can get pretty bad pretty quickly if you let the enemy turn come too quickly. So high cost cards become really dangerous, more so than they are right now. This one's pretty good though. 4 cost and it attacks all the enemies and removes all their buffs. I might go with this one because Rulo's really good, and the cartridge that she's using, Captivating Crystals, gives me 5 armor at the start of the fight. I don't even have to do anything, just immediately 5 armor. That's actually really useful, and Rulo, like I said, I mean, she only costs 1 point. And she gets a lot of attack. If you can kind of like lengthen out, you know, stretch out your turn, Rulo can actually do a lot of damage, so... Alright, let's discard. Who should I get rid of? I got one that I wasn't a fan of. I wasn't really a fan of her. And... I'm not really a fan of her. I might get rid of Lanterna, actually. Because you need to discard cards to really take advantage of her, and I don't have a lot of cards that discard cards. So... And also, she's kind of useless. Airi, Sakura Saka. Okay, we'll get rid of her. No. We'll get rid of her. We're gonna get rid of Lanterna. And I'll get a scout ticket. Let's see what we can get. Let's do Ruthless Phoenix. Oh, it's the laser. The laser chick. Fret not, I will slaughter all of them. I like her confidence. Okay, so we can either do a 1-star or an event. What's coming up? She looks straight out of Neptunia. You're right. You're right, she does. Okay, you know what? If I do the event, I can go to a shop next. So, let's do the event. Oh, it's Lanterna's Quiz Corner, okay. So we at the Black Army serving King Dutchtoli have someone both bewitching and cruel. She is the army's second in command. Who is it? Okay, well, it's not going to be the queen. Let's go with Kalmia? Oh no! I hit that good for nothing maid was the. Damn, I didn't know who she was. Okay, well, I still got a scout ticket. That's not bad. Okay, so what I'll do then is I won't discard any bullets yet. I'll just buy another scout ticket, and now we have two. So I can get two more bullets. So let's do a third-year student that is unwell, I guess. Okay, she's not bad. Two bound. Which means they can't heal. I'm pretty sure. But it attacks everybody. So that's not too bad. God. Okay, well, I have one more scout ticket. Let's go with Vigorous Phoenix. Attack power plus one for each active drone. Okay, well, I don't have any bullets that give me drones. You did pick unwell after all. Yeah, you're right. She reminds me of who's the ice girl from Toho? Is it Cyrano? I think I butchered that. You would know, though, Rose, who I'm talking about. Okay, let me get rid of... I'm actually going to get rid of her. She's not going to do much for me. Because I don't have any drones right now. And I don't like that she costs 8 and only does 8 damage. So I'm going to get rid of her. How dare you make me type Cyrano's name? That's hilarious. I'm sorry. Tommy, is this like a gacha game that just costs one flat rate instead of microtransacting you to fuck? Pretty much. It feels like a gacha game, right? And yeah, it is just one cost. I don't even think there's any DLC or anything for this game. But it's not easy. That's the thing. The game is not easy. I've never actually beaten the first stage before, because like the stage is broken up into several maps. I think it's like 3 maps or something like that. I've never actually beaten the first stage. To be fair, I haven't played a lot. I've only been playing this for the past like couple days. But it's not an easy game. It can really screw you over pretty quickly. Her pronunciation is all over the place, so you're good. Okay, good. alright, let me see. How am I gonna start this? Yeah, that'll be 16. Okay, this'll work. You see Chirno yourself. Okay. It's usually Chiruno? Okay. In Japanese dialects. That's okay. That actually makes a lot more sense. I always tend to butcher words that start with C. very specific, I know, but holy smokes. Okay, so this one, it only costs 3, it does 15 damage. But it inflicts 3 damage on me, and it has exclusion, which means that once you use the bullet, it's removed from play for the rest of that fight. It's basically sent to, like, the the Shadow Realm. What else can we get? Attack power plus 1 for each bullet in the graveyard. That could be pretty good. If I get this one, like, right at the end of my deck, this could actually be really good. I think this one's the best, so I'm gonna go with this. 15 attack for 3 costs is just way too good. Okay, so we're gonna have the second boss. C is a very Swiss Army knife of a letter, so I don't blame you. You're right. Chitoli? Oh, that's funny. Because she's the opposite now, because that's apparently what the bug does. It, like, makes whatever the opposite. So she was the Black King, now she's, like, the lowest rank. Boss time. Okay, so the laser makes attack drones gain plus 2 attack power, but again, I don't have drones. So that's gonna be kind of useless for me. Okay, I'm gonna save this. That duo. She'll heal me. Okay, this is why I saved my discard, because those two enemies are going to do a lot of damage on the next turn. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to try to whittle one of them down.
この一層、ハル様のために。
Okay, so the rook is gonna do 23 damage to me, and the boss is gonna do 31 damage to me. Okay, I'm gonna start off, we'll discard her, Riko, because that'll give me 20 defense. And then, let me see. We'll use her, that'll give me an extra 6. And he'll do a lot of damage, so we'll do that. Okay, that's gonna be 5. Let me think. Okay, I'm gonna have to take some damage. There's not much I can do about it. Just looked at my upcoming games to play. God, there's so many good games there. I'm glad you think so, Tommy. I actually, what's funny, I made that list a while ago. It hasn't changed that much, but I have picked up like quite a few games that I would like to add to that list. There's only so much space on the list, so I'll probably keep it the way it is now, and then I'll kind of like move things around as I get to other stuff. I haven't had much time to stream recently, but I'm going to be hopefully trying to pick it up, you know, pick up the pace a little bit. Going into like the new year. All right, how are we going to do this? Let's see. Okay, so she's going to buff herself. Okay, so she'll be doing 50 damage on the next turn. I can use him to discard Riko. That'll give me 20 defense. And then from there, I'll just try to do as much as I can before I get destroyed. Okay, that was pretty good. I was able to lower the damage of that attack quite a bit. Okay, nice. We got 30 damage extra on that turn because we hit 10 combo. And then what's she gonna do? Okay, she's gonna... I forgot what the cloud means. Buff me or buff herself or debuff me, one of them. Okay, yeah, we won. There we go. $300 coins, that's gonna be really useful. Okay, so we get King Dishtoli, and let's pick a good one. This one, 5 armor at the start of combat. Same thing here, and this one is 12 or more monochrome, so I'm gonna go with one of these. I guess we'll go with this one. So she attacks 5 times. She costs 20, which is ridiculous. But she attacks 5 times, and her base attack is only 3. But she has burst 1, which means that every time I use a bullet, that turn, her attack goes up by 1. So if I can use a lot of weak bullets and get her attack up, I mean, even if I can just get her attack up to like 10, that's 50 damage if I use her at the end of the turn. And she hits everybody because she's got 5 range, so... She's in the throne room. Okay. Okay, this is as far as I've ever gotten. I've never beaten this map before. I don't know if it's the last map of this stage, but yeah. So we're not gonna do a 2-star, especially since I only have 35 health. So we're just gonna hope this event doesn't suck. Oh, this one's good, actually. Queen Sicilian. So we got a healing item, a scout ticket, and she healed me a bit. Which is pretty good. That's another 2-star. We're not going to do that. And I don't want to do this because then I'll be stuck with a 2-star. So we'll do another event. This is ours territories. If Yuzwana's gettings past us, pains the tollings. Well, screw you. We're not paying you squat, and I'm not running away, so I guess we're gonna beat the crap out of her. Use Woods defies us. The Horn Slimes will show you spheres. All right. I like her music. Okay, we'll get rid of the slimes first. This kind of sounds like Pokemon music, a little bit. In before this is actually a 3-star battle, right? Four, okay. Oh, that was a really good draw. Okay, good. And then I'll do... Let me see. I'm actually going to take a lot of damage. Or maybe not. No, maybe not. Next turn, I'm going to take a lot of damage. Okay, that's one slime down. She's gonna give defense to everyone on her next turn. Okay, I'm gonna take 20 damage. There's nothing I can do about that. 23, because this is gonna hurt me. Okay, let me see. 5, 5, so 28. Okay, you know what? I think... Okay, we can get rid of the slime on the next... on this turn. Especially with this, actually. It's 12... Oh my god. Okay, so she's gonna do 29 times 2 on her next turn. I'm gonna have to do something about that. Because I only have 39 HP. Okay, well, I'm not gonna kill her. That's just not gonna happen, so... I'll try to heal and give myself shield. Wait a minute, I might be able to pull this off. Okay, Maybe not. Hold on. Okay, this is 9. Okay, let's get rid of her, because she's pretty useless. Hold on a second. Gain 1 armor at the start of combat. Okay. This is 4. Okay, what's she at? She's at 101. This will do 50. This will do 30. Ugh. I think I'm gonna die, but I'm gonna die just, like, so close to actually, like, finishing her off, which is so sad. Oh, wait a minute, hold on a second, I have items. I forgot about that. Never mind. Okay, I'm not gonna die. We'll just use my items. Hold on a second. I forgot I got these items. Okay, we're good. I'm not gonna die. Doesn't really matter what I use now. The item clutch, right? Wow, she gave me a lot of gold though. Holy smokes. Okay, so we get an item. The next bullet use has minus 10 cost. 2 break on all foes, or inflicts 3 countdown on 1 random foe. Alright, back what I miss. I thought I was gonna die against that slime boss, that slime controlling boss, but I remembered I had a couple healing items on me, so I used those and managed to survive. I'm down to one last collectible, and nothing I see online is talking about where it is. Oh man, that's always really rough. Okay, let's get rid of something. I know I've got some bullets that suck. Let me get rid of some that I'm not going to use. Okay, this one I don't feel like is any use to me. Neither is this one. And this one costs more. So I think I'll get rid of this. And we'll get another scout ticket. Alright, let's go with Composed Expert. Oh, it's this chick, Tsuyo Hagino. Or Hagino. Attack power plus 1 for each bullet in the graveyard. Alright, and I will get... I should probably buy some healing items and stuff again, because that actually saved my butt. So we'll get one of those. Wow, that's actually pretty useful too. Yeah, I'll get this. Okay. And we'll go here because this will be a free healing spot. I'm not gonna do the fight. Let's do the event. I'm so hungry and tired. Please give me food. Okay. What? You fell for it. Oh my god. Well, that sucked. I'll buy another potion. Let's get another ticket. I'll discard this bullet because... Actually, hold on. Is there another one I'd rather get rid of? No. Yeah, we're gonna get rid of this bullet. Utterly bamboozled, yeah. Couldn't have said it better myself. Next bullet has 5 attack, plus 5 attack and minus 10 cost. That's pretty good. But I can't afford that, so. Okay, let's go with Black Magic Brawlers. Oh, she's pretty good. Scorpia. Draw 2 cards, inflict 7 poison, and she does 11 attack for 6 cost. It's not bad.
こいつはたった今完成した新作でな。ちょうどいい。お前、ちょっとテストしてみないか?大丈夫、大丈夫。死にやしないさ。多分な。
Oh, do I have another ticket? Where did I get the other ticket? Okay. Let's do Strict. I guess we'll do Strict Stage Princess. Inflict 5 feeble, gain 2 shield. Okay, the reason these cards aren't that great, or bullets, I keep calling them cards. Cards are bullets, same thing. Is because bosses can't be affected by debuffs, from what I can tell. So if you have a bullet that's primarily used as like a debuff to like lower their attack or lower their defense, that kind of thing, they don't work against bosses. She has like a different art style. She kind of looks like a Disney character. A little bit. Okay. So, let's heal. Alright, so that's all my health back. Okay, I can either do a fight or I can do another event. The event could go badly. Yeah, screw it. Let's do the event. Oh, it's Natsu. I messed up while brewing and made more potions than I need. Could you take them off me? Heck yes! Oh, that worked out. Okay. Nice. Whoa! She gave me 2. Okay, that's actually super good. That's gonna come in clutch for the boss. I'm not gonna fight this 3-star because the last time I did that, I got demolished. So we'll go here, and because I don't need to heal, we'll do the swap cartridge. So the cartridge, like I said, if you guys look at the bottom of the bullet there, it says cart. And then, for example, this one is Ghostly Zippers, and this one gains 1 shield, okay? That's what's changing. So it's random. I don't get to choose what the new cartridge is going to be. But you could end up getting a really good one. So I'm going to choose one that has a bad one. Yeah, see, she's kind of useless. She needs a better one. Oh, she's the reason I'm getting free healing at the cafe. It's because her cartridge taking breaks at rest blocks is free. Let me see, what else could I do? Okay, I think I'm gonna change hers, because hers just isn't doing much for me. Cost minus one to Dragon Palace bullets? I don't know if I have any Dragon Palace bullets. Let's change it again. Hold on. The next season's bullet used after this one has cost minus three. Okay. I'm still neither here nor there. No worries, Chris. I've never actually beaten this boss before, so this might be the first time. See, right off the bat, she's doing... on her next turn, she's doing 36 damage. Right away. It's brutal. Okay. Okay, I poisoned her, so she's gonna be taking pretty good damage just from that. Okay, this is gonna be attack power plus one for each bullet in the graveyard, so if I can just keep using bullets, this is just gonna get stronger and stronger and stronger. Okay, this is going to be a freebie turn because she's going to be powering up this turn, so...
What?
She's gonna do 70 damage on the next turn. It's crazy. Okay, we'll try to get some shield. Okay, this will do 25. I could do a lot of damage this turn, because this will do 25. These two are going to go up to 21. So it'll be 25, 21. And then this is getting another 5. This will be 26. Now I can finish off with something else. She's doing 36. Oh god. Okay, well here's the thing though. We just got all these really good healing items. Suck it, boss. Okay, so let's use this, because this will be minus 10 cost to the next bullet, which means this one's only going to cost 2. And then we'll get some shield. And... Okay, hold on. I'll gain 15 shields. Oh no, I waited too long. I was gonna use her. Now she's weak because my deck refilled. Okay. So in that case, was this 6? 30? Oh, okay. Okay, well she's not gonna attack me on the next turn, so that actually works out. I'll poison her. Discard her. The poison killed her. Nice. Okay, that worked out really well. Sorry guys, give me just one sec. I got someone else for the next game. Hey, so that's the first time I've ever actually beaten the stage, which is really nice. Oh, that's funny. It shows all my bullets that I used. And we get some rewards. So these have a chance now, I believe, of showing up in future runs. Jeez.
では、私の出す条件をすべてクリアできたら、考えてあげてもいいですよ。そうですね。あなたに出す条件は。いや、私はルイ・ロペス。黒の軍団を追って旅をしている勇者なんだ。君、良ければ私と一緒にこの世界を救ってみない？
Okay, let's check our messages. So Hikaru is the next character we use? So the next game is Seasons of Love. So this is the new stage. I'm gonna end it here, guys, because I would have to jump off pretty soon anyway. So yeah, this was a super bullet break. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you very much, everybody, for hanging out. It was nice to do a stream. I haven't done one in a while, so you know, always enjoy sharing these games with you guys. And I really appreciate everyone, you know, who hopped in. Thank you guys so much for being here. I hope you all have a great rest of your weekend. I might do another stream sometime this weekend. We'll see. If not, I'll hopefully be able to do some more before the end of the year. So, yeah, look forward to that. And again, thank you guys so much. Have a great rest of your night. And I will see you next time. Take care.